It is fully packed here tonight. I'm Todd Grisham, and we're going old school tonight here inside the Grand Theater. Alongside me, English fighting legend Johnny Nelson.
I feel like a fraud. How have I got these ringside seats?
It's time now for our tale of the tape. And it's Nigel the Dark Destroyer Benn. He comes in at a... It's Nigel Benn, the Dark Destroyer, one of the greatest English champions of all time. This legendary middleweight fights out of London, England. Roy.
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Fighting out of the red corner from London, England, here is a middleweight and super middleweight champion of the world, known as the Dark Destroyer, introducing Nigel.
Welcome inside this unique environment, a beautiful theater, ready for a fist fight.
Venues like this, it can make a...
And there's the bell to start the round. When are we going to see a jab from these two? And he wasn't ready for that counterpunch. How about that time counter shot? You don't want to go tit for tat in there in this fight. When someone punches that hard, you don't want to trade shots. Nice counter. It is standing room only. Every seat has been sold in this amazing theater.
This is that place you want to say, I fought, I've been there, and now we are here.
Can they figure out the combination to this safe? It's knockout or bust for both of these fighters.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. It's like a match made in heaven.
What we are seeing. That uppercut just missed. That counterpunch caught him clean. He threw the hook, didn't land. The exchange punches. The courage on display here is incredible. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Every time they throw a shot, they get countered. Let's talk about Benn in that last round. Pretty dominant round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round.
Dominance, without a doubt, made it look so, so easy.
We're hoping for an all-action slugfest. That round was complete domination. Let's see if we can shake things up here in this round.
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round. Everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down.
Ronda Rousey once told me when she gets into a fight, her mentality was minimum effort, maximum efficiency.
How you deal with a slugger, you've got to use brain over brawn, bull in a matador, pop, jab, move, get them angry.
That hook was thrown with some bad intentions. That one lands. We're at the halfway point of this round, and both of these fighters have had their moments. Still could go either way. Throws the uppercut but misses.
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them more than happy.
This counterfighter believes in the anything you can do, I can do better. They'll let you throw a punch first, and they'll answer you and usually hit you harder.
Hard, I understand what you're saying, but you've got to be on this. You've got to be on it. You've got to be a pro. You've got to think right. Concentrate.
This is a very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Talk about Ben in that last round. The game plan does not seem to be working here. What's he have to do differently?
The bell, sometimes it can be the sweetest sound.
They ring the bell, and here we go. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to bluff it. They've got to bluff it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab, rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then put the pressure on.
Has to be careful for that receipt. It's always coming. Fighter will say no mas. Nice counter punch right up the middle. You've got two evenly matched fighters in this weight class. It sometimes comes down to who's in better condition. And that hook misses. So far, both of these fighters have had their moments. Tried to score with the uppercut.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
As we enter the final frames of this bout, Johnny, what have we seen so far?
A gift. What a gift it is to have a chin where you know you can walk through anything and everything. When you let those shots go and it's just bouncing off and they're walking you down, it's so demoralizing. It absolutely breaks your heart. What else can you do?
This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Counter punching. Talk about Ben in that last round. He is down big time on the scores.
Wow, it's like two different leagues.
We're hoping for an all-action slugfest. Coming off a very tough round, let's see what they do here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
Swing and a miss with that hook. That jab doesn't score. Done with that counter shot. The work rate is down. The head isn't moving as well, Johnny. Fatigue is starting to set in.
This is what you're going to get. You're going to get speed, good footwork. You're going to get punches thrown from head to body. You can get a lot of toe-to-toe. When you got fighters at these weight divisions, they'll stand there. They don't need a ring. They need a phone box.
Pretty close fight here in this round.
So close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
Swing and a miss with that hook. Neither one of these fighters want to see the judges' scorecards. Nice exchange here from both men. There's a body shot, and that one looked like it hurt. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. Let's talk about Ben in that last round. And a round that seemed like an eternity for them finally comes to a close.
Every second, every minute.
And there's the bell to start the round. That corner has got to find a way to get some momentum behind their fighter.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him. Tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
Those counter punches have to hurt. Here we go with the lightweights. Get ready to see some blazing hand speed and fancy footwork.
Oh my goodness, so that little Yorkshire Terriers, they're never gonna give up.
So much for boxing. This is a fist fight. Nice counter shot. Figure out the combination to this save. Punch lands.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. Just like a match made in heaven.
Missing with the hook. Well, Johnny, I know it's still early on, but have you been surprised by anything you've seen?
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, if you are not fit, that is the worst place to be, having second thoughts in the ring.
Back and forth they go. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Been in that last round. Well, there was no doubt about who won that round.
I seriously hope the judges.
They ring the bell, and here we go. This fight has been very one-sided. What are we going to have in this round?
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round. Everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing, because you've won that hands down.
The charts action from both of these fighters. Misses with the jab. Hey, it's the featherweight division. You're going to see a lot of speed in this fight.
Middleweights always gives us a class. If you've got two class middleweight fighters, you are in for action. I'm quite sure right now, if you know your boxing, there's a certain fighter, I would just say marvelous, but some fighters were unbelievable in middleweight.
At the halfway point, and both of these fighters know the round is still up for grabs.
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them, more than happy.
Can't throw out a lazy jab in this fight. You're gonna get knocked out. And he scores with the counter. Misses with the jab. That hook was thrown with some bad intentions. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. Let's talk about out Benn in that last round. That was almost a 10-8 round, complete dominance.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter.
And there's the bell to start the round. After a really strong round, let's see if they can finish the job.
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down.
Has to be careful for that receipt. It's always coming. These two featherweights are gonna let their hands go, you know that.
Look back in the history books, some of the best fighters in the world were the middleweights. Yes, the glamour division is the heavyweights, we know. But I'm telling you now, you look right there, these guys are on it. Fast, sharp, powerful. It hurts, and you can imagine that being you. They're the size of an average man.
Which one of these athletes is gonna say, I can't take it anymore? Back and forth they go in this round. The momentum continues to shift.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other because no one dare do anything out of turn.
And so far, the offense has been better than the defense. Rest for the weary. I'd like to see someone use a jab here to establish a boxing presence. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. And he wasn't ready for that counterpunch. Talk about Benn in that last round. Well, it's no secret who has the advantage after that last round. Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy. If they keep this same kind of pace up, they've got this fight.
We're hoping for an all-action slugfest. Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here.
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down.
What do you think of what we've seen so far from these two boxers, Johnny?
You've got to be courageous when you get in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain then.
Nice idea with the jab, but does not land. They're both going for the KO. It's so obvious. These two are the perfect dance partners. They both want the knockout.
They're so close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
One punch changes everything in this division. It's the heavyweights.
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
Big hook thrown, but it doesn't connect. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. At some point, the corner needs to decide we have to protect our fighters. Let's talk about Benn in that last round. Well, he is glad to have heard that bell.
You know, I've been in fights like that. When you think, come on, bell, ring away. You walk back to the corner like you've just seen the sun.
the bell, and here we go. Off their stools and ready to go. Let's hope this round is more competitive.
Now he knows he's been hurt. He's going to come out and put the pressure on. He's going to throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart, because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs have gone. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
Every time they drop their guard, they get caught. Which one of these athletes is going to be the first to get rocked? Nice counter punch right up the middle. This fighter's certainly not going to out-throw their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
Oh my goodness, what pace, what pace. They're like, do you know what a Yorkshire Terrier is, Todd? They're like little Yorkshire Terriers.
I can't believe we're only halfway through the round.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. She's like a match made in heaven.
Gotta let your hands go a little bit. It's okay to be aggressive now. Do you believe this? You know, with lightweights, these guys are going to be lightning quick.
I've never seen a fighter so fast in my life. How'd you deal with this? You've got to hope they run out of steam.
Beautiful counterpunch. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Whoa, wait a minute. What a shot. Talk about Ben in that last round. As bad as boxing judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that round.
Dominance, without a doubt.
And there's the bell to start the round. And Johnny, can he keep the momentum going after that last huge round for him?
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing, because you've won that hands down.
Looking to land the hook. That uppercut just missed. That big hook doesn't land. We both know who the bigger power puncher is. There's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
This is why I love the little guys. This is exactly why I love them. Look at them, toe to toe, heart for heart. You know, mano a mano, they're letting the shots go.
Those who thought this would be a mismatch, you are sorely wrong.
Perfectly matched, skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them, more than happy.
Nice counter shot. They threw the hook, it didn't land. The jab doesn't quite connect. Punches coming. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Let's talk about Ben in that last round. What would you tell this guy? He's got to do something different.
Needs a knockout, without a doubt. Needs to go out there and think, right, you know what? Next round, you get it.
They ring the bell, and here we go. Not the start that they wanted, but let's see what they can do in this round.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to bluff it. They've got to bluff it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab, rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then put the pressure on.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but when you're dealing with someone with so much speed, you've got to get your timing right.
Some fighters are just gifted. Gifted with such hand speed, footwork, movement. They are gifted. They are the chosen few.
Well done with that counter shot. You don't want to trade shots. That big hook doesn't land. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Well, just a couple rounds left, Johnny. What's your assessment so far?
The middleweights are the best you can ever come across. Obviously, the glamour weight is a heavyweight, but the middleweight is the size of the average man or woman. When you get in there and you're letting the shots go, you've got power, you've got speed, you've got pace. You can stand, you can dance, you can do everything.
And is this the beginning of the end? Oh, and just when you thought it couldn't get any worse, it's a knockdown. We enter the final 10 seconds here in a pretty dominant display. Let's talk about Ben in that last round. That'll be a 10-8 round for We're hoping for an all-action slugfest. Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
What a heavy knockdown. How are they going to come back from that? They staggered back to the corner. They've got to freshen them up, alert them again, get them back on point again. This round, they've got to coast around. Don't get involved. Give yourself another 3 minutes to get your head clear.
Both men step back for just a moment. Walk away from each other and then run right back into trouble. And this is a you hit me hard, I'll hit you hard type of fight. This has been a very competitive round as we reach the midway point. Generally speaking, you don't watch heavyweights to see a boxing match. You want to see a fist fight.
This is about ego. Get your ego in check, Todd, because if you fight a man that is used to doing this, he's confident and comfortable doing this, why are you giving him that chance to dance that dance? Step out of the way, box him. Frustrate him, because if you let him get away with it, he'll close you down.
Look at the hand speed and footwork between these two elite level middleweights. Neither one of them wants this to go to the judges' scorecard. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. As close as we thought it was, and this fight is a split decision win.
A split decision? How one-sided does it have to be? A split decision? Who's doing this job? Todd, tell me, come on, talk to me. That is not a split decision. Ridiculous.